Hello everyone, welcome you all on our online lecture series on engineering metrology subject. This is our fourth chapter, screw thread and measurement, in which we have different instruments for measurement of screw threads and its parameters. First of all, we will see that what is mean by screw. Here we have its definition that you have to write in examination also. A screw thread is a ridge of uniform cross section in the form of helix provided on outer or inner side of cylindrical or conical surface. Here we have one object and on its outer periphery over the uniform cross section we have formed a ridge in the form of helix, and at its internal part, you can see here, at its internal portion, we form a ridge with a helical structure. And this is called as screw threads. Generally, when we form external threads, that time such items or such products are called as bolt, stud, and where we form internal threads, that element are called as nut or the machine component, where the internal threads are manufactured. Here we have another object. This is a pipe and we form the external threads from its one end, and this is another element which is having the internal threads. This element we can call it as a nut section and this section as a bolt section when we use it as a fasteners. Now we will see its applications. We know that screw threads or the element which are having threads are used for different purposes, such as bolts, screw and stud. Such elements are used as a fasteners to tight two elements. Here you can see that these are the two elements which get fastened by nut and bolt arrangement. The second application of screw threads are used for power transmission also, and in some cases the long screw are used for controlling the accurate linear movement of component. This type of screw you have might been seen in lathe machine also. This is called as lead screw, which is used for controlling the accurate linear movement of component. At its top face we hold one element which get travel from this point to this point, and when we control this movement, at that time it happens due to the accurate manufacturing of thread. And these threads are also used for accurately measurement in different devices. When we use some devices for measurement, in some cases we have to use different screw element also, and to provide linear movement or precise movement of particular object travel, that time we use screw thread element in different machines also. Now we will discuss its classification. This question is asked in examination for 4 marks. Explain classification of screw thread. Now we will discuss one by one. In screw thread, we have generally 3 main categories. First one is number of threads. Second one is hand of thread. And third one is position of threads. In number of thread, we have again 3 subcategories. First one is single thread Second one is double thread, and last one is triple start threads. These are the starting of threads. Generally, we use double and single start thread in fastening and power transmission devices. The next point in classification is hand according to hand of threads, in which we have again two types. First one is right-handed screw and another one is a left-handed screw. It means depending upon the manufacturing or reach of threads, whether it is in left-hand direction or right-hand direction, we divide screw as per its direction. And the main concept behind this is, when we use right-handed, in such condition, when we move the nut in clockwise direction, that time it get tight, and when we rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, that time it get loose. But in a reverse condition, when we use or prefer the left-handed threads, that time when we have to fastening or tightening the object, that time we have to rotate that nut in anti-clockwise direction only. This is the second main point, that is types of hand of thread. And the last point, that is third point, is position of thread, where that threads are manufactured. And the two points where we can manufacture, that is the external thread and internal thread. Here we have one element, nut and bolt, in which we have engraved manufactured threads at its outer part. This is called as external thread. And when we produce a thread in internal section, that time this element is, or this type of threads are called as internal threads. In this way, we can able to classify according to position of thread, that is external and internal threads. Now we have some diagrams or photographs for left hand and right hand threads also, so you can identify whether the thread is right handed or left handed. Here we have two diagrams. First one is right handed threads and second one is left handed threads. In this way, we can draw the diagram in examination also for left hand and right handed threads. When we want to fastening or tightening this type of threads, that time we have to rotate it in clockwise direction, and for left hand thread we have to rotate it in anti-clockwise direction. Here we have its two figure individually. Here we rotate it in anti-clockwise direction and it get advance, and when we rotate it in clockwise direction, that time it get advance. Now you have to write classification of screw in your notebook and definition and application of thread also. In next lecture, we will see different nomenclature of screw threads which are asked in examination for 2 to 4 marks. Thank you.